The Liars Club was given to me as a gift at just the right moment for me when I was trying to figure out how to express myself in a new art form. And a friend of mine, he came by and he gave me a copy of The Liars Club, and I dove in it. Mary's language was so colorful, so muscular, so funny, so tender and heartbreaking and true. The Liars Club, it was without any self-pity, which gives it elegance and gives it timelessness. I feel like my intelligence is being respected because I'm not being manipulated by anything maudlin or self-pitying. The nobility of here's what happened and here's my sensibility and this is how it filtered through me. I just sense something really lyrical and playful and powerful in her writing, and I just knew that she was a natural born songwriter as well. A little time passed and we got together and we became fast friends and sat down and started writing songs. And in really maybe a 15 month period, we wrote about 15 songs, just kind of on the fly, and wound up making a record called Kin, songs by Mary Karr and Rodney Crowell, which was a very joyful piece of work for me, and a really great collaboration of between Mary and I on songs. And we had Nora Jones and Emmylou Harris and Lucinda Williams and Chris Christopherson and myself and Vince Gill and Roseanne Cash and Leanne Womack and everybody else that's cool performing on that record. And in the process, I made a lifelong friend. Honestly, the most difficult part for me is figuring out the order in which the words go. Because I come from, you know, a family of bullshitters, you know, I know how to tell a story. And I know when the story's right. It's just the real challenge for me is to get the words in the right order. I'm a songwriter by birth, by nature. But sometime back, you know, 10 or 12 years ago, I decided I wanted to try to write in another form. And I just kind of intuitively drifted into memoir. And because of Mary, who is a friend of mine, she put me on to the childhood biography of a place, Harry Cruz, which I knew nothing about, but at Mary's suggestion, I read it. And I think it's brilliant because it opens with a memory that's not even his memory. I also like Movable Feast too. But everybody does. I love Mary. Just, I love her through and through.